Здравейте! Јас сум Владимир Мисев, председател на Институтот за демократија и денеска сум во својство на модератор на првиот дел од јавната презентација, која ќе биде проследена со дебата, на која ќе учествуваат реномирани говорници од политичката и академската јавност на тема од надворешната политика. Пред да почнеме со дебатата, би сакал да ја дадам можност на господја Ања Чимек, официален представник на Германската фондација Конрад Аденауер во Македонија да ве поздрави. Ања.
Добар ден. Дие министер Поповски, дие професор Малески, Dear Antonio Miloszowski, Excellencies, distinguished guests. On behalf of the Konrad Adenauer Foundation and the Institute for Democracy, Sociedad Civilis, it's an honor for me to welcome you to our discussion on foreign policy and aspects of international diplomacy. When we planned the different topics of this year's Politische Misla, it was clear that we must deal with the topic in 2013 because we have a very important occasion as a background. December 2013 marks the 20th anniversary of establishing diplomatic relations between the Republic of Macedonia and the Federal Republic of Germany. The relation of both countries to each other, despite of challenging framework conditions, is characterized by friendly normality and naturalness. This anniversary itself will probably attract less interest in public, which is a pity, because the relations of both countries were and are fundamental for the positive development of the Republic of Macedonia and its way to membership in the European Union and NATO. The beginning of diplomatic relations can be considered as a crucial step towards further stabilization of the country and the region. It can certainly also be seen as a turning point for the position of the Republic of Macedonia in the international community at that time. In fact, there were primarily Germany, together with Great Britain, France, Italy, the Netherlands, and Denmark, that supported and promoted the UN membership of the Republic of Macedonia. And still today, its efforts towards the integration in the European Union and the NATO, the future of the Republic of Macedonia relies also on the support of Germany and other European partner countries. I will not go into details now concerning the German-Macedonian relation, but the first article of this new edition of Politička Misla, written by Macedonia's ambassador in Germany, Cornelia Utevska-Gligorjevska, and the honorary consul for Macedonia in Düsseldorf, Mr. Holger Michael Arndt, starts with the history of this diplomatic relation. Moreover, we present in this edition other interesting contributions with regard to the challenges of modern foreign policy and diplomacy. And today's discussion with our distinguished guests will also go deeper into the topic. But before the start, I would like to make some remarks about last week's very important event in Germany, the German elections. Chancellor Angela Merkel and Germany's CDU-CSU have achieved an outstanding overwhelming victory. Germany's governing party has captured 41.5% of the vote and 311 out of 630 seats in the Bundestag, five short of an absolute majority. CDU and CSU, which is the Christian Democratic sister party from Bavaria, have achieved the best election results since 1990. This is largely due to Angela Merkel's popularity, but also to the weakness of other competitors, especially the Social Democrats and the Greens, but also the liberal FDP, from which voters massively deserted to the CDU-CSU. Both in style and in substance, Mrs. Merkel represents the middle ground of German society. The result is also a resounding approval of her pragmatic policies at home and abroad, and her cautious but determined handling of the euro crisis. But Angela Merkel can neither govern alone nor will she be able to continue the coalition with the Liberals, who with 4.8% dropped out of the Bundestag for the first time in the Federal Republic's history. After a major voters' shift from the CDU-CSU to the FDP in 2009, there was a massive backflow from the Liberals to the Christian Democrats this time. The FDP will have to reinvent itself outside the Bundestag, now being present only in a part of the state parliaments. The most likely partner for a federal coalition at the moment are the Social Democrats. With 25.7% of the vote, they have slightly improved upon their disastrous result of 2009, but remain far below hopes and expectations. The SPD did not manage to present a coherent alternative to Angela Merkel's pragmatic policies. Besides, jobs and social justice, the classical SPD topics, did not catch on in a situation in which most Germans feel things are basically okay in economy. Coalition talks will be very rocky and difficult, maybe precisely because of the weakness of the SPD vis-a-vis a CDU-CSU that is 16% ahead of them in the votes. But a grand coalition will secure a solid majority for the government in the Bundesrat, the second chamber, which is crucial for most of the legislative projects. The Greens have experienced a political catastrophe, dropping to 8.5%. 2 years ago, after Fukushima, they were about to overtake the SPD and well above 20% in the polls and some state elections as well. They have squandered this capital in a uniquely inept campaign for higher taxes, nonsensical proposals such as a vegetarian day, but above all, heavy-handed approach to their own past proposals to legalize sexual relations between adults and minors. Moreover, at least politically, Angela Merkel's energy transition, the so-called Energiewende, the shift from the nuclear energy to renewables, has paid off by depriving the Greens of their core topic for mobilization. At the moment, there are also discussions about a coalition between the Greens and the CDU-CSU, but this might be ruled out because the Green Party members will not go for it. Another political surprise is the sensational success of the Eurosceptic Alternative für Deutschland, Alternative for Germany, with 4.7%, almost in the Bundestag, after having been founded only in February 2013. They will now focus on the European elections and are set to get three or more members into the European Parliament. Even more than up to now, they will become a serious competitor to the CDU and also the FDP, aiming at the unease of much of Germany's center-right electorate about bailouts and the transfer of competences to Brussels. This fear will make Angela Merkel cautious vis-à-vis the SPD's demand for easing fiscal consolidation. The probable grand coalition may well be rockier than the one in 2005 to 2009. The SPD has to overhaul its political identity while in government, which is never easy, and it may be tempted to at least threaten to leave the coalition and go with the Greens or with the Left Party, after all. Moreover, a newly self-confident CSU from Bavaria will take also strong positions of its own in some questions. But no matter what kind of coalition or government we will have in Germany, I reckon one thing is quite clear as it comes to foreign policy, and that is that policy sees credibility as the prerequisite for success, and a credible and effective foreign policy is based on feasibility and not so much on dogmatism. Germany has never had a tradition of restraint in its foreign policy. With its diplomacy and the assistance of various institutions, such as the foundations affiliated with political parties, like Konrad Adenauer Foundation, Germany has always had a good cooperation with other countries. These policies have often been very successful with regard to building civil society or party systems or re-establishing a working democratic order after domestic upheavals. Germany's foreign policy is value-oriented, and its agenda strongly revolves around Europe. The European integration process, the transatlantic partnership, working for peace with a campaigning for universal and inviolable human rights, and managing globalization, including topics such as resource security, climate protection, water-related issues and migration are the cornerstones of Germany's foreign policy, and regardless of the upcoming coalition, there will be no strategic shift in Germany for Germany's foreign policy. The politicians of the newly elected German Bundestag are aware of their responsibility, and there are parliamentarians who are especially interested in Macedonia.